Today I'm going to share with you a new function in Excel that allows you to create functions. A function to create functions. It's called the Lambda function. This is currently only available in the beta channel. This is a function that's both for Excel beginners and experts. Because even if you don't end up creating your own Lambdas, you need to know what they are because you'll probably end up using someone else's Lambda. I'm really curious to get your impression of this function, so comment below as you're watching this and let me know what you think. Personally, at first I thought it's a nice to have, and then I saw recursive lambdas. It changed everything. Now I'm not going to talk so much because you need to see this. Now this is going to blow your mind. In this example, we have a list of names and the skills of each person. Now, unfortunately, we have mistakes here because some people put in Office 365 where they should have put in Microsoft 365 instead, or PowerPoint with a space where it should be PowerPoint. So here we have a list of before and after, and we want to get these corrected. So notice that some of them are going to require multiple corrections because they have made mistakes for every single skill. What we want to do is go to each cell and loop it through the before. Whenever it comes across a match, it should take the after version of it, make the replacement, and put it through this list again. So it's similar to a for next or a do while in VBA. We're going to do this with a formula. Check this out. I've already written the lambda for this. My function is called mega replace. So the moment I start to type it, it shows up here. It needs the text that I want to replace. Then it also needs the start of my before table and the start of the after one. Now I'm going to fix these because this is a table, and the moment I press enter right here beside the table, it's going to add this as a part of the table. Now when I do this, press enter, take a look at what's going to happen.
Wow!
Everything is replaced. Look at this. Office 365 PowerPoint, Microsoft 365 PowerPoint written correctly. The one where we had a lot of mistakes, that was this one, for example, it's all corrected. This is an example of a recursive Lambda. Now we're going to get to the engine of Lambdas in a second, but let me show you a practical example of a Lambda that's not recursive. So let's say in your workbook, you generally need to do a certain task, which is to sort certain fields by the sum of another field in descending order. So for example, you want to sort department by the sum of salary. Kind of like doing a SUMIFS on your salaries by department and then sorting them just by department. Because notice that the sales department is repeated here. So are the other departments. Now you can create a lambda for this so that all you have to do is type in your own custom function. I called mine sort by sum. This one just needs two arguments, the column that you want to sort, so let's say this, and then the column that has your numbers that you want to do a SUMIFS on. And then you close bracket, press enter. I have departments sorted by the sum of salary. Now, if you don't trust me, we can double check it here. I'll do a SUMIFS quickly. My sum range is this. My criteria range one is this. And my criteria one is this. And hash to make it spill and press enter. Notice I have the correct sorting. Now, because this is a lambda, I can apply it to anything I want, as long as it has a similar structure. So sort by position, I go to sort by sum, and then I take the position column and then the salary column. Close bracket, press enter, and I have my positions sorted by the sum of salary in descending order. So this has already been programmed that it always gives it to me in descending order. And the reason I did this is something that I might use often in my workbook. Now, how are these set up? Well, let's cover the basics of lambdas right here. What are lambdas to begin with? These are just functions that you create. These functions act like machines. Once you've created that machine, you can put through it other ingredients and reuse it as often as you want. This means that you don't have to recreate the machine every time. So let's do an example here. Let's say I have this list of prices and I want to calculate a 30% discount rate. So what would be the price after a 30% discount? To do that with a formula, I just go B4, multiply it with 1 minus 30%, close bracket, and press enter. If this is a formula that I'm using a lot, I could turn it into a machine. This way, I can reuse it with other similar ingredients. So how would this look as a lambda? Well, the great thing about creating your machine with lambdas is that you can create it directly in your formula bar. It's a function. So I'd start with typing in lambda, and then you need parameter or calculation. So basically, each argument is either a parameter or a calculation. Well, anywhere you see cell references, these are going to become your parameters. So here I'm just referencing B4. B4 is going to be a parameter. And you can call this parameter anything you want. Now, I'm not really creative with names, and I don't like to waste time thinking of good names, so I usually just go with ABCD or XYZ. So I'm going to call the parameter B4, which is my cell reference, A. This is my calculation, and I have to mention the parameter at the beginning. So it's A, comma, so then I go to the next argument, and it's always that the last argument of your lambda is your calculation. Anything before are your parameters. Now I've created my machine. I need to close the bracket to close the lambda function. So what happens when I press enter? Well, before I do that, just take a look to see if you're subscribed to this channel. If you aren't yet, consider subscribing. Let's take a look. When I press enter, I get an error. Why? Because I've just created the machine, but I'm not putting anything through it. I need to put in an ingredient in there. To test your machine on the grid here, you can do it by putting in a cell reference. To do that, at the end of your lambda function, open the bracket and do a cell reference. That's going to act like your parameter. So since I only have one parameter, this B4 is going to become A, and it's going to get put through my machine. Now when I press enter, I get what I got back before. Now obviously, this formula right now is not so useful. It's better just to have what I had before. The advantage of machines like this, like the lambda function, is that you can give this a name, and then you can reference this anywhere on the grid. And we're going to see this in a second, but I want to show you a lambda that has two parameters. So let's say instead of 30%, you want this to be dynamic as well. So you can turn it into a parameter. I'm going to call this one B. Now, because this machine needs two ingredients, A and B, I have to have them as parameters on the side here. So it's A, comma, B, comma, and last is my calculation. Okay, now what's going to happen when I press enter? Let's check it out. It's not going to work. Why doesn't it work? Well, the machine needs A and B to work. I've only given it one thing. I've only given it A. So what is B? Well, it's 30%. So you can either do a cell reference or directly type it in. Now, when I pull this down or send this down, I get the same results. Okay, so how can I turn this into a name that I can reuse? Well, once you test that your lambda works on the grid, you can copy it. So actually, let's copy the equals as well. So you just copy the machine part of it, and then you go to Name Manager. So under Formulas, Name Manager, you create a new name. You can call this anything you want. I'll do Calc Discount, and then paste in my machine in here, and OK. Now, whenever you use more than one parameter, I recommend you add in the comment what each parameter is used for. So something like A equals your value and B equals your discount, and OK. Okay, so now we have this as a lambda. This means that whenever we need to call this, all we have to do is type in the name of our function, which was calc discount, and it needed two things, which was this and our discount rate. I'm just going to put the discount rate here. Let's fix it. Close bracket, press enter. I have nothing, so it's 30. If I put 20%, now I have a 20% discount. This is something I can reuse anywhere in my file. Now let's take a look at the practical lambda I showed you before. How can we create that? Well, the first step to creating lambdas is to try it out on the grid. This works for lambdas that aren't recursive. All you have to do is figure out the function you need first, then turn it into a machine, basically a lambda, and then give it a name in Name Manager so you can reuse that machine anywhere you want. In this case, we want to sort any column that we want by the sum of another column. So here, for example, I want to either sort the department or sort the position in descending order based on the sum of salary. So I'm going to pick position as my guinea pig. I'll try to write out the function that works, and then I'm going to turn it into a lambda. So I'll start from the inside of the function and work outwards. I need the SUMIFS function. The sum range is this one. My criteria range, that's position here, and the criteria itself, well, it's the unique values of my position column. Now when I close and close the SUMIFS and I press enter, my results are going to spill because it's giving me the sum of each unique position. Now, because I don't want to get the values back, I actually want to get the position back. I can put this inside the sort by function. Sort by needs an array. The array is what you want to see in the end. I only want to see position in the end, but not all positions. I want to see the unique positions. By array is my SUMIFS, and I want to sort this in descending order. So I need a minus one here, close bracket, press enter, and I get my position sorted by the sum of salary. Now we can quickly test that just to make sure it works. I'll do a quick SUMIFS. This is my sum range, my criteria range, and my criteria itself. I want it to spill, so I'm going to use the hash, close bracket, press enter. It works. Now that I've created my machine, I'm going to turn this into a lambda. So let's go and start off with lambda. First thing is to figure out our parameters. Well, that depends on how many different references we have. I have two different references. It's either this one or this one. The C4 to C19 reference, that's where I have my labels, and the D4 to D19, that's where I have my numbers. So I'll be better this time. I'll go with A as my labels and num for my numbers. So I need two parameters here. Now, the last argument, remember, is the calculation now. And I have to replace every time I see a cell reference here, I have to replace it with my parameters. So this is going to become my A because C4 to C19 are my labels. So that's going to be A. I'm going to replace this also with A and this A as well. D4 to D19, that's going to become my number parameter. So I'm going to change it to num. My lambda is done. Let's close the bracket, press enter. Well, it's not going to work because I can test it to see once I pass the ingredients to it, is it going to work? I'll pass department this time and then comma and my numbers. Okay, so you have to respect the order of the parameters. When I close bracket and press enter, I get sales, finance, and procurement. Okay, so this works. Now I can turn it into a name that I can reuse anywhere I want. So I'm going to press Control C, go to formulas, name manager, add a new name, call this sort by sum, and paste in our values. Now I can quickly add A equals labels and num equals numbers, and okay. Okay, so sort by sum is my new machine. So now I can use it anywhere. I want to sort division by revenue. I'm going to go with sort by sum. The machine needs two things. First is the column I want returned, and then my numbers. Close bracket, press enter. I have it sorted. I can use this anywhere I want in my workbook. Now, the last one and the most exciting one for me is the recursive lambdas. Now, because this video is already so long, I'm not going to do this justice if I rush through this, so I'm going to keep this as the topic of our next video. Okay, so tune in next week and let's talk about recursive lambdas. Okay, so that's an introduction to the new Excel lambda function. Next week, I'm going to cover recursive lambdas, and we're going to do that last example together. Let me know what you think. Do you have the beta channel? Are you able to test lambdas? Let me know below. Now, I assume since you're watching this far, you enjoy the content of this channel. So if you do, consider subscribing. And I'm going to see you in the next video.